Hey friends, it's Joel Richardson, and this is The Underground. Welcome to this week's episode of The Underground, a program that explores the testimony of the biblical prophets, the gospel of Jesus Christ, current events, and how all of these things relate to you and me. Now, in this week's episode, The Underground is on a field trip, and so I'm sitting right now, right in front of what many people believe is the Cave of Elijah. We're in Saudi Arabia at the mountain known as Jebel al-Lawz, or Jebel al-Lawz. This is the mountain that many people believe is the real Mount Sinai. Personally, I am convinced. I think the biblical and the historical evidence and just the reality on the ground is pretty convincing. If you could see clearly behind me is a giant sort of pile of rocks that have carvings of calves and bulls all over it. This is believed to be the actual altar that the Israelites made when Moses was on the mountain, and they made the golden calf and began giving themselves immediately to idolatry. So this is just a massive series of mountains. It's a massive site. I mean, it takes hours just to drive from one spot to the next. And you know, many who follow this program, they're aware. Many are not aware. Back in the 1980s, in 1984, Ron Wyatt came and visited this place. He was attempting to prove that it was the real Mount Sinai. He was he entered Saudi Arabia illegally. He was kicked out. He got arrested in prison for about 90 days. He got kicked out. He came back. A few years later, Bob Cornuke came and climbed the mountain, again, Mount Sinai, and got some images and so forth, and wrote a book on this. And then from 1992 to 1997, this just a wonderful, amazing couple named Jim and Penny Caldwell, they came here about 14 times, and they just had thorough documentation of all of the sites around the mountain. And one of the things that they found, which hadn't been discovered before, was the split rock. And this is just something that if anybody has seen it, it's amazing. Even just pictures are amazing, but pictures really don't do it justice. This massive rock split down the middle, which in so many ways matches the biblical criteria of what you see described in the Bible. It refers to it. He said, the Lord says, Moses, I want you to go up and strike the rock of Horeb. So you had this rock was clearly a landmark. It was a notable landmark. Moses strikes it. And in the Psalms, it says, O Lord, in the wilderness, you clave the rock. You split the rock down the middle. And so you have this massive landmark of a rock. I mean, it just stands out, split down the middle with clear signs of water erosion, not only at the base of the rock, but coming down the sort of hill that it sits on. So when we're looking at the mountain, Jebel al-Lawz, which is actually a couple peaked mountain, this whole mountain, which is, they call it brown laws or block laws, which is the whole top of the mountain is a distinct type of rock as opposed to the granite, which is, you know, sort of all over the place, which is much lighter. The whole top of the mountain is a dark, a blue, green, and black. And you have the split rock, you have the golden calf altar, and then even right down here, which you can't see, is another altar that people believe that this is the altar that Moses made according to the commandment of God to offer up sacrifice. And so it's an incredible archaeological site. Many other people have come here, people that live in the country and so forth that have visited. Not a lot of people have made it public, of course, because oftentimes the Saudi authorities will come in and confiscate all their footage and sort of, you know, maybe even arrest them and harass them, this sort of thing. I just want to very briefly just touch on something. Many of you are aware of the fact that the Crown Prince, Mohammed bin Salman, has been talking about building this mega city known as Neom. Neom is a city that, according to his plans, it will be 33 times larger than New York City. Okay, and it would take up this whole sort of northern northwestern corner of Saudi Arabia, up close to Jordan, Israel, and Egypt, up at the top of the Red Sea by Eilat. And, you know, he's got initially $500 billion designated to build this city. This city will encompass this entire area. This mountain, this entire archaeological site, will essentially be right in the middle of this. Now, again, I said I'm going to be brief. I'm personally praying, and I want to invite you all to pray with me as well, that the government of Saudi Arabia, that as the crown prince steps in, it's likely that he'll step into power relatively soon, that they will do everything they can to protect this site, this entire area, as an archaeological site, that they'll begin letting in Western archaeologists to begin exploring and looking at these things. We actually found some amazing cave art as we were making our way here earlier today, pictures that I have not seen in any of the other photographs and so forth of the site. So pray that they'll let Western archaeologists in, and pray because Mohammed bin Salman has said that he's going to open up the country to tourism. The country right now is going through massive, drastic changes, all sorts of reforms. He's looking to modernize and really he's looking to change the nation in such a way that it would be able to compete economically with the rest of the world and will not be reliant and contingent solely on oil. So he's trying to diversify the economy. The result of this is that he is actually forging a friendly relationship with Israel. I mean, who would have thought this? That, 10 years ago, that a NATO ally, Turkey, would be emerging as an Islamist dictatorship and Saudi Arabia would be emerging as a potential ally with Israel. And again, this pertains, the reason that they're doing this is because of security matters, alliance against Iran, and also the diversification of the economy. So there are big, big changes happening here in Saudi Arabia. Pray that as we go forward, that this site would be protected. Anyone that has been here has been in awe. We've been, really, today's our first day. We left at 6 o'clock in the morning. We've been hiking about 5 hours. It's been a pretty tough hike. As you can see, the sun's coming out and it's starting to get pretty hot. We've got a lot more to see and a lot more to do, but we do have to move on. I just wanted to say hello, sort of touch base, and let you know that we're here, and hopefully I will get back safe and sound to be able to share this with you all. So until next week, I just want to thank you for being with us. As always, we appreciate your support. Go down, if you're watching this on YouTube, and subscribe. And if you're not a subscriber, then subscribe. And likewise, go to my website at Joel's Trumpet and do sign up for my newsletter. I probably send out about 2 or 3 newsletters a year, so there's really not much. So that's it, friends. We'll see you real soon.